Hey everybody, this is Steve Christensen, and in this video I'm going to answer 10 common questions about age-related macular degeneration. Question number 1. What is macular degeneration? Macular degeneration is a degenerative disease which causes damage to the macula, the part of the retina which gives us the clarity and fine detail of our central vision. Our eyes are like a camera, and the retina is the film in our camera, as all the light from our surroundings is focused onto the retina. This information is then sent from our retina to our brain to be interpreted into what we see. The most important area of the retina, with the greatest concentration of light-sensing cells, is called the macula. And in macular degeneration, these light-sensing cells become damaged. Macular degeneration is a generic term that refers to various degenerative diseases of the macula. But in this video, I will only discuss age-related macular degeneration, a leading cause of severe vision loss worldwide, especially among older Caucasian individuals. Question number 2. What are the symptoms of macular degeneration? Because macular degeneration involves damage to the macula, which is once again the area of the retina that corresponds to our center vision, the symptoms of macular degeneration involve one's central vision. More specifically, patients with macular degeneration often complain of blurry central vision. They may notice this blurry central vision as difficulty reading, or trouble recognizing faces from afar, or trouble completing normal daily tasks, or even needing more and more light to complete these daily tasks. Patients with macular degeneration may also notice distortion or waviness to objects in their central vision, such as the side of a doorway or a street light. Several of these are also symptoms of cataracts or other conditions, so it is important to see your eye doctor if you notice changes in your central vision to determine the cause. Question number 3. My doctor gave me a square grid and told me to look at it every day. What is this grid and how do I use it? We often give patients with early or stable macular degeneration a grid such as this one. This is what is known as an Amsler grid, and it is used to alert you and your doctor to changes that, if treated early, could help prevent or prolong vision from being lost due to macular degeneration. To use this grid, simply close or cover one eye, and with your glasses on, if you wear them, hold the grid about a foot away, looking at the dot in the very center. While still maintaining focus on the center dot, check to ensure that all the other lines in the grid appear straight. Or in other words, be sure that none of the other lines in the grid are distorted or wavy. If things appear normal, uncover that eye, cover the other eye, and repeat the same process. If you do notice wavy or distorted lines in the vision in either eye, call your eye doctor right away. Question number 4. I've heard there are two forms of macular degeneration, the wet form and the dry form. What does this mean? Dry macular degeneration is the most common form of the disease, and if you had a room full of 100 individuals with macular degeneration, 85 or even 90 of them would have the dry form of the disease, which typically involves slow, gradual damage to the light-sensing cells in the retina. The dry form of macular degeneration involves the accumulation of small yellowish deposits called drusen that are made up of lipid. These deposits can be present even in normal individuals and likely do not cause age-related macular degeneration, but certainly having drusen increases a person's risk of developing age-related macular degeneration. The wet form of the disease, wet macular degeneration, may also include the presence of drusen, but wet macular degeneration specifically refers to the growth of an abnormal blood vessel from beneath the retina. This abnormal blood vessel is known as a choroidal neovascular membrane, which then leaks, and it often even leaks blood, leaking into the layers beneath and within the retina. This fluid then damages the light-sensing cells of the macula. Fortunately, we have several treatment options to help control the growth of these abnormal blood vessels and the harmful fluid they leave behind. Question number 5. Will I go blind from macular degeneration? Macular degeneration, if very advanced, may severely limit your vision to the point of you being able to only count fingers or see hand movements in your central vision. This level of vision loss is considered legal blindness, and certainly may have a severe impact on your daily life. But macular degeneration will not lead to complete and total blindness. Your peripheral vision will typically be preserved, but will unfortunately not provide the same crisp clarity because the still healthy retina outside of the central macula, which is damaged, does not have nearly the same density of light-sensing cells. In other words, age-related macular degeneration may lead to severe visual impairment and even legal blindness, but will not cause you to be completely and totally blind. Question number 6. What is the treatment for dry macular degeneration? Researchers are working vigorously to discover new treatments for dry macular degeneration, but there is currently no treatment to restore vision that is lost from the dry form of this disease. A very large study sponsored by the National Eye Institute determined that several minerals and antioxidants may prevent patients with an intermediate stage of the disease from going on to develop advanced dry macular degeneration. These minerals and antioxidants can be purchased without a prescription as what is known as AREDS2 supplements, which you will take by mouth every day. If you have dry macular degeneration, ask your doctor if he or she thinks you might benefit from taking these vitamin supplements and antioxidants. Question number 7. What is the treatment for wet macular degeneration? While we do not currently have great treatment options for the dry form of the disease, we have excellent options for the wet form of macular degeneration. Remember that the main characteristic of wet macular degeneration is the abnormal blood vessel growing from beneath the retina and leaking fluid, which then damages the light-sensing cells of the retina. We fortunately have several options to help control the abnormal blood vessel growth and bleeding in wet macular degeneration. These medications are given directly into the eye by your ophthalmologist, and they may be needed as frequently as every month to control the disease. Question number 8. My grandmother or grandfather has age-related macular degeneration. Will I get macular degeneration? Both genetic and environmental factors have been found to be associated with the disease, but macular degeneration does not have a clear and well-established inheritance pattern like many other diseases. It is estimated, however, that approximately 15-20% of individuals with age-related macular degeneration have at least one first-degree relative, such as a sibling or a parent, with the disease. Question number 9. What can I do to prevent macular degeneration from developing? Several risk factors have been linked to macular degeneration and should be avoided, including smoking, obesity, high blood pressure, and diets high in fat and cholesterol. A diet rich in green, leafy vegetables, and antioxidants may lower risk of developing the disease. And as was mentioned previously, the AREDS2 trial found that certain minerals and antioxidants may prevent the progression from intermediate to advanced forms of especially dry age-related macular degeneration. And finally, question 10. What vision aids and other resources are available to those with advanced age-related macular degeneration? Individuals with advanced macular degeneration may have significant difficulty with normal tasks such as reading, paying bills, using a telephone, and other daily activities. Inasmuch as the central vision may be severely diminished, many options exist to help increase the projection of images from just being focused on the damaged area of the macula to being projected onto the areas of the retina that remain healthy and unaffected by the disease. This can be done via handheld magnifiers, digital magnification devices, phones with larger buttons, and other features that are available on a smartphone even, or on a computer. Talk with your doctor to see if he or she might know of a low vision specialist who may assist you with obtaining magnification devices and teaching you about the various accessibility features that are now available on your electronic devices. I hope you found this information about age-related macular degeneration to be helpful. Once again, this is Steve Christensen. Thanks for watching.